So let me do a quick camera test, and we have taken some photos from this device as well before doing this video, so we will show you those photos as well. As of now, I'm going to take this photo in artificial light and let's see how does it come out. And the moment you tap on the screen, it will take the photo and it will do the focusing on its own. You cannot tap on the screen and focus. And let me show you this photo which we have taken first of all. Yeah, so this is the one which we have just taken right now. You need to make sure that the camera is stable to get proper clarity and details in these photos. And color production is again good but not great. You can see that the original object actually looked like this, and this is how it looks like on this phone. As far as display is concerned, it is not exactly the same colors, but I would say pretty close to the actual object. Let's take a look over some of the other photos which we have taken. This is the one which we have taken from the front camera in artificial light again. And this was kind of a room in which we do not have much light in our office. So this is how the photo looked like. It is good, I would say, in terms of the clarity, but in terms of colors or brightness, it could have been better. Let me take a look over the other photo which we have just taken. So this is how the other photo looked like, which we have taken in daylight right now. And this photo looks good, I would say, in terms of clarity, in terms of details. Everything is looking nice. So in daylight, you can expect better photos. And this is another one which has been taken in daylight, which has got good amount of details and very good color production. So once you have natural light, you can take very good photos from this phone in day-to-day usage, especially when you are out. This is another photo which we have taken in, I can just go back to the one. Yeah, this is okay. The interface is slightly annoying. Over here you have another photo which we have taken in low light, and this is how it looks like. Again, details are not that clear. I cannot see the details properly, but we took this photo with flash as well. Let me show you that one. So this is how it looks like, especially with flash. And over here we have the photo with flash, and this time it has captured better details and better clarity, and the colors are again not that great but decent enough for a device like this. Let me take a look over the other photo which we have taken. This is another photo which we have taken. So most of the photos which are captured in low light, they will come out to be dark. They are not very bright. This is something which I have noticed as far as the rear camera is concerned. But if you have good artificial light, then you can capture good details, but the color production is also not great, I would say, in these photos. So details are going to be nicely captured, but the color production is something which I'm not very happy with, especially when you take photos in artificial light or in low light from this phone, from the rear camera. Front camera is decent, I would say, in daylight, and in low light it is also doing a decent job, if not great job, I would say. So let me just go back to the camera interface and show you some of the camera options and what all you can do. So here we have the camera options. You can take photos in HDR auto mode, which is supported. You have flash option over there. You can also change focus and exposure. This is how you can actually do that. You just need to enable this, and then you can change focus and exposure. This is mainly for the exposure, I guess. I'm not sure with okay, you can actually change the focus point, but you cannot tap on the screen to do the focus. So you have to slide it where you want to focus, and then it will focus on that area, and then you can change the exposure like this. Apart from this, if we take a look over the night mode, we have a low light mode as well. We have the video mode, in which you can record high definition video at 1080p, and the slow motion videos can be recorded at 720p. Talking about the front camera, I would like to toggle to the front camera first of all. So right now we are in the HDR auto mode, and let me toggle to the front camera. And over here in the front camera, if we take a look over the resolution of the videos I can capture, this is again saying 1080p. So I can record high definition video at 1080p from the front camera as well, which is a good thing, I would say, not bad at all. And let me just toggle to the rear camera again. So the front and the rear camera are good, but again, the low light performance from the rear camera is not that great as what we were expecting.